Hello friends, in this video we are going to talk about optical amplifiers, the types of optical amplifier and its various uses. So let's begin with the topic. Amplifiers. We know that in case of electronic circuits, amplifiers are basically used for improving strength of the signal. So similarly, the concept is applicable to optical signals also. When the light signal travels a longer distance, due to the environmental effect, the various losses occurs during the transmission of the signal. So in order to overcome it, we require to amplify, or we can say we require to regenerate the signal at particular interval. So for that purpose, optical amplifiers are used. So let's see the optical amplifiers in detail. So optical amplifier, as its name implies, it basically operates in optical domain. And there is no interconversion of proton with electrons. Instead of using a regenerative repeaters, which requires optoelectronic devices for sources as well as for detectors, together with an electronic circuit that can help to operate the entire circuit properly. For example, the electronic circuit includes pulse splicings, then retiming and reshaping of the pulse. The optical amplifiers are placed at a regular interval along a fiber link. So by using the optical fibers or by using the optical amplifiers, we can regenerate the signal without any loss. And it provides a linear amplification of the transmitted optical signal. The optical amplifiers, in principle, provides a simpler solution, that is, single inline component which can be used along the optical fiber. And it can be used for any kind of modulation at any transmission rate. In between the transmitter and receiver, to boost the power of the signal, the different amplifiers are required. So basically, optical amplifiers are nothing but a power booster to the signal. Now let's look at the general representation of optical amplifier. Here, the figure shows the general representation of the optical amplifier, which is having an input signal. Fiber gain medium is nothing but an optical amplifier. Now, there are two main approaches to the optical amplification. To have a concentrated on a semiconductor optical amplifier, which basically utilizes the stimulated emission from the injected carriers, and fiber amplifiers in which gain of the amplifier or gain of the circuit is provided either by a stimulated Raman or Bernoullian scattering. We are already aware about a stimulated Raman scattering and Bernoullian scattering, and it is also possible by using a rare earth dopant. Both the types of amplifier, that means the semiconductor and fiber. Also in fiber, especially the rare earth dopant and a Raman amplifiers have the ability to provide a high gain over a wide range of the spectral bandwidth. This bandwidth comes under the optical bandwidth, making them entirely suitable for the optical fiber system amplification. That means we can use these amplifiers, especially the rare earth dopant amplifier and the Raman amplifier, for the variety of application, as it provides a maximum gain over a wide spectrum of bandwidth. Semiconductor optical amplifier offers an advantage because their smaller size, and also because they can be integrated to produce a subsystems, which becomes an essential element of the current optical communication system and network. So in most of the application, we find the optical amplifiers which are to be used are nothing but a semiconductor optical amplifier, as they are available in smaller size as well as they provides a high gain, that means enough gain for the system so that it can be used in the variety of applications. Now let's move towards the gain provided by the optical amplifier. The typical gain provided by optical amplifier is in the range of 1.3 to 1.5 micrometer wavelength region. It may be observed that the semiconductor optical amplifier, which is also called as SOA, and erbium doped fiber amplifier, which is also called as EDFA, and a Raman fiber amplifier provides a wide spectral bandwidth. As this is also discussed earlier, because of this, we can use these types of amplifier in a variety of applications. Hence, this optical amplifier lend themselves into the application which involves wavelength division multiplexing. So especially the area of applications of this type of amplifier are nothing but the wavelength division multiplexing. But by contrast, the Bernoullian optical fiber amplifier provides a very narrow spectral bandwidth, possibly around 50 megahertz, and therefore it cannot be used for a wide spectrum. It could be, however, used for the channel selection within a WDM system by allowing amplification of a particular channel without boosting other nearby channels. So, where a narrow bandwidth requirement is important, in that case, we can use a Bernoullian fiber amplifiers. The SOA, that is semiconductor optical amplifiers, exhibits low power consumption as compared to the other types of amplifiers. The optical amplifier provides a much simpler solution in that it is a single inline component which can be used by any kind of modulation in the optical fiber communication system. The EDFA, that means the erbium doped fiber amplifier, is most commonly used optical amplifier in majority of the application. Now let's talk about the low impedance front end. Now here we can see the figure of low impedance front end. The three basic amplifier configurations which are frequently used in the optical fiber communication system, mostly in case of receiver. The simplest and the most common is a voltage amplifier, which provides an effective input resistance RA, which can be shown in figure here. So we have a detector and bias circuit as well as a voltage amplifier circuit, which is mostly used in majority of the application. In order to make the suitable design choice, it is necessary to consider both bandwidth as well as noise, because both are going to affect the transmission of signal. In most practical receivers, the detector is get loaded with a bias resistor RB and an amplifier. The bandwidth is determined by the passive impedance, which appears across a detector terminal, which is taken as load resistance RL in a bandwidth relationship. However, RL can be modified in order to incorporate the parallel resistance of the detector bias resistor RB and the amplifier input resistance RA. Now the modified total load resistance RL is given by a formula, that is RTL is equals to RBRA divided by RB plus RA RT into L, which also equals to RBRA divided by RB plus RB. To achieve the optimum bandwidth, the values of both, that means RB and RA, must be less. So if the values are less, then it is possible to achieve the optimum bandwidth required for the proper applications. Now let's talk about a high impedance, that is integrating front end. The second configuration consists of high input impedance amplifier together with a larger detector bias resistor in order to reduce the effect of thermal noise. Because when we are considering a detector or when we are considering the optical amplifier, two important parameters we are going to consider, that are nothing but the bandwidth and noise. So in order to reduce the effect of thermal noise, the high impedance front end circuits are used. This structure tends to give a degraded frequency response, as a bandwidth relationship is not maintained for a wideband operations. The detector output is effectively integrated over a large time constant and must be restored by using a differentiation process. Now, to achieve this, a correct optimization is required, and that correct optimization is performed at a latter stage that we can show in figure here. We have a detector and bias circuit, and we have high input impedance voltage amplifier, which is further given to the equalizer in order to achieve the optimum bandwidth. Therefore, the high impedance front end structure basically gives us a significant improvement in a sensitivity over a low impedance front end design. But the major problem is it creates a heavy demand for equalization, as it has a problem of limited dynamic range. That means the limited dynamic range is basically defined as a ratio of maximum input signal to the minimum input signal. So these are the disadvantages of a high impedance front-end amplifiers, as it requires a demand for the equalization and it provides a limited dynamic range. The third one is transimpedance front-end. This configuration is largely overcome the drawback of the high impedance range, that is the drawback of demand of the equalization and a limited dynamic range. So these two drawbacks get overcome in case of transimpedance front-end circuit. So the drawbacks are get overcome by utilizing a low noise, high input impedance amplifier with a negative feedback. The device is therefore operate in a current mode amplifier where the high input impedance is reduced by a negative feedback. We are already aware about a various advantages of the negative feedback. So here we are utilizing that advantages and we are achieving to overcome the drawbacks of the high impedance front end circuit. So the equivalent circuit of optical fiber receiver incorporates a transmit impedance front end is shown in figure here. So here we are utilizing a negative feedback which overcomes the drawback of high impedance circuit by utilizing a reduction in noise. Now the circuit which we saw, that is the equivalent circuit, and in that equivalent circuit the parallel resistance and capacitance are combined into RTL and CTL. The open loop current to voltage transfer function, that is HOL omega, for this transimpedance configuration corresponds to the transfer function of the two structures. So this is what about the various optical amplifiers that are used in the optical fiber communication system and various applications for regenerating the signal by placing them at a regular interval. There are three different types. First one is semiconductor optical amplifier. Second one is erbium optical amplifier, which includes Raman optical amplifier and Bernoullian scattering amplifier, as well as the rare earth doped amplifier. Majority EDFA is used in all the application because it provides a wide range of application and it provides a wide wavelength in a bandwidth spectrum. So all this is about optical amplifier. So I hope you understand this topic. So thank you very much for watching this video.